We first told you earlier in the week in a breaking news alert that Springdale police arrested the last two suspects in a deadly drive-by shooting. Springdale police arrested these two near Clarksville. Police say Rodolfo Martinez is the shooter and Giovanni Vasquez Sanchez was driving the getaway car last weekend's shooting. A 20-year-old was shot in a driveway on Savage Street in Springdale and died at the hospital. Washington County sent a report of possible faulty bridges to the state, but the attorney general said she can't investigate by law. The county judge has the responsibility, and the highway department hasn't said if it will inspect the 35 bridges in question. This is all due to a video that claimed there's been possible faulty construction for several years. In Commitment 2016, former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee's radio program will end May 1st. And on Friday, we learned that he'll make an announcement about running for president from his hometown of Hope, Arkansas, May 5th. His TV show ended earlier this year. A student who lied about being sexually assaulted in the U of A parking garage was arrested this past week for filing a false report. Police say when they brought her in after her story had been made public for a few days, she admitted to lying about that assault, but she didn't say why. Sweden's next court date is next month. And Whirlpool announced on Friday it has reached a settlement with most homeowners whose properties were contaminated by the company. Their properties were contaminated with a cancer-causing chemical called TCE that Whirlpool used for years. Homeowners will be paid the amount their property values declined plus attorney fees. 54 homeowners settled with the company. With your weekend review, I'm Craig Cannon, 4029 News.